During this section, I want to talk about data validation within an Excel list. Now, this is a very important concept, so before we jump in and get our hands dirty and start to work with the various data validation tools that Excel carries, I want to talk about the need for data validation. Understand why this is important before we start to implement it. And this will hopefully open up some doorways for us in understanding why this is important and how we should be implementing this within our Excel lists. So a while ago, I was doing a training at a company, very specific group. They had a very specific need. Here's what happened. This company had, prior to me arriving, had sent out to a third-party company the need to create surveys for their clients. This third-party company said, great, we're going to create the surveys for you. We'll send them out to your clients. We'll collect the data. We'll send the data back to you, and you can do your reports based on that data. Well, here's the problem. That third-party company that created the surveys, they sent them out. The clients filled the information out. When the data came back in to be reported off of, they found out that there was zero validation on the data being collected within those surveys, which meant when people were putting things in like their phone numbers, they were typing in their phone numbers all sorts of ways. When people were putting date values in, they were formatting their dates and numbers and text and using different symbols, and it was just wacky with the results that were coming back from these surveys. It was a hassle. So now when the data came back and people wanted to report off this data, it was nearly impossible. They had dirty data. They got dirty data into the system. They got dirty data out of the system. So they weren't able to effectively report off of this data. Before they can create the reports, somebody had to go back in and clean the data up. So the training that I got involved with, what we talked about how we can validate the data so that when somebody's inputting their results, their data, we're telling them, hey, you did it wrong. Fix that. Format it the right way. Ooh, that's not a valid value. Make sure you pick something from this list that we're supplying you. You got to pick a valid value, and you got to format it the way that we want it to be formatted. Take a look at what I have open in front of you. This is the example file that, again, comes with this course. So once again, if you haven't downloaded it, go back to lecture number 2 and download the file called Excel 102 Exercises. This is the one that we use throughout all of this course. So open in front of you, I've got the example file and I've got sort and filter here. So think about the concept that I've just described to you. We need clean data. We need to make sure that people are putting correct data into our list here so that later on when we sort or filter or summarize, we're doing it based on clean, effective data. So what's something you might validate inside of a list like this? Well, you know, if it's me that's going to work inside of this list, you might want to give me specific makes or models that I have to choose from. Because if it's up to me and I'm just down here entering new records, I'm probably going to mistype something. I'm a horrible, horrible speller. Okay? I blame it on technology. I use Word to do my spell checking, which is great, but now I can't spell. Okay? So don't rely on users to type stuff in correctly. I might misspell Oldsmobile or Cutlass Supreme, right? Give them choices to pick from. Ooh, if it's an automatic, if it's a smoking car, if it's a convertible, if it's insured, they're just Y and N results, yes and no's. That's all you can pick. It's not maybe. Maybe it's a convertible. I don't know. Well, no, it's a yes or a no. Okay? So we give them clear-cut direction. Tell them exactly what they need to do. You can only pick from these makes or models. You can only use N and Y's for the four columns there. Ooh, rates. Rates can only be from this minimum value to this maximum value. So we can set up these types of data validation techniques within Microsoft Excel. So we're going to take a look at how to incorporate this and get clean data into your list. And ultimately, when you start sorting, filtering, summarizing, pivot tables, you're going to be able to do it effectively because you've got consistent data inside of your Excel lists. So jump into the next lecture. Let's take a look at how you can validate your data within a list like we're looking at here.